this is the true wall. 3 hours of solid gameplay and have not seen Bugsy's gym. That is definitely a wall. I could have spent the night watching the basketball games. It would have been more entertaining, maybe. But I like streaming. Even when the runs suck, streaming is fun, so. It's all good. I'm guessing the Spurs won the first game because I think 25 point lead after the first quarter or something. Have not seen any of the second game. But I don't like either team. I don't like the Rockets. I don't like the Warriors. Ow. Probably not. There isn't that much crossover between the gaming community and the sports. There's not really a sports community. It's a lot of people on Twitch are not into sports at all. I'm always a little bit pleasantly surprised when I find someone who has some interest, not like a hardcore fan or anything, just some interest in sports. Like, I attended college with the group of, well, I considered a career in sports journalism, and my peers were people who are like, I live and breathe sports, and it's the purpose for my existence, and like, they were cool people. It's just like, I could not identify with that kind of passion for just watching, basically. Like, if you play it, I totally understand, but if you're just, like, observing other people and reporting on it. It's just not something I could really identify with. I strive to succeed at a much more worthwhile activity of grinding for good luck in a video game 8 hours a day. What's up, Pat? One encounter to rival. Dang. The problem with sports betting, like, I tried it with, like, not real money, but just, like, pretend money. The problem is, like, the biggest opportunities to profit are from, like, insider information, so it's just about who you know, rather than how well you can observe the competition. That is, if you're actually trying to make money from it, which is what I would do if I, you know, that's what I would want to do. If you're just doing it for fun, you know, knowing that it is not something that is expected to make money, I guess. I did fantasy sports like 2 or 3 seasons in college. It was kind of fun at first. I got into it. I was monitoring the games, but then after a while, just got sick of it. 13 attack. Golder is correct there. Emerald gold symbols, that's the run that has like 600 RNG manipulations. It's not a real gamble. Interesting. It's now night time. Can't remember what Monokuma says in Danganronpa. The full line. But I can't do the voice, the Monokuma voice. No. Poliwag.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Victor. Speed. Oh. I missed all three. That is not good. This is such a good time, but this Totodile sucks. Yo, M17, thank you for the sub, man. Much appreciated. I'm just gonna get it. I mean, yeah, this is fine. Just get a Poliwag and I'm good. Thanks for the luck. Yes. Thanks, Ganja. It's a hot crit too. What's up, Sakura Queen? Thank you for the luck. So we do pansy strats here, I think. Yeah. Good ol' pansy strats. My defenses are quite good, and then my attack and speed are quite bad. If I could just get the speed here. Got the attack instead, so... Rival 2, please! But I can't. Not a good play. 15, 17, 20. Actually, it would have been very stupid to deal with that. Like, really stupid. God damn it. This looks so good. It looks so good. The stats. The 1646 with both slaves. The execution. There's just one teeny little problem. I have 0 or 2 speed. God damn it. Ah, this run would be so hot if this was, like, 6 speed. Are the people in the middle part of politics, though, or are they just trying to stay out of it? Is the middle really versus anyone? No! Need every second I can get. So I really want to be able to hit Benny and still continue. Right side. Gunner pass. Set photon. Thank you. 2. SPD is speed, SPC is special. Why do I have 18 speed? Sup, Jody Kid? Wait. How do I have... The fuck do I have 18 speed? Wait. Oh, I'm dumb. I'm so... Wait. Okay. Was it 16? Yeah, so I don't know how this happened. I have 4 speed, so it's actually fine. Why am I tired, dude? duel each other? You mean, like, duel each other the way they did in the 18th, 19th century with guns? I mean, I see your point, but it's just like, why would you do that? Unless you were committing suicide with another person. It's a group suicide of sorts. I get it. I read up on my history, but it's kind of a bizarre example. Why do we need guns so much in the first place? Military, son of a bitch. Military spending, see, every time that people bring up, like, the use of guns, it's like, it's a very specific example, as opposed to one that applies with regularity. You do not need guns to defend yourself. This is just a very short-sighted way of thinking. There are specific situations in which having a... I don't know how that... I guess I was at rage. Yeah, okay. There are specific situations in which having a gun will help you survive, and there are specific situations in which having a gun will get you killed, and there are situations in which it's not needed at all. And then, of course, there are risks in allowing them into civilian hands. But it's just not... It's just flawed logic to say that, like, if I have a gun, then I will be better off if someone... is a potential threat. Like, it just doesn't work that way. It's not that simple. You actually have to know how to use it properly, and very, very few people do. There are more people who use guns dangerously and irresponsibly than people who know how to use it properly to defend themselves. Wow, really, girls? Alright, here comes the speed tie. The fuck does that mean, fend off crime? It doesn't matter though, because if you want to talk about numbers, you talk about the number of people who die to gun violence in the US, and then you look at all of the countries that don't allow guns in civilian hands and the number of gun-related deaths they have. Or the number of, I mean, obviously that's gonna go down, and you have to look at other statistics, but... I just find it to be ridiculous that people defend guns so much when it's just, there's, guns are made to kill people. It's not a good thing. I understand that there are some complexities to the issue. And of course there's politics, but it's like, the things that you ought to be defending are things that are used for good. That's not how it works here, that's for sure. Sometimes you need to kill people. Alright, new discussion. How's everybody doing? What do you guys think about pizza? What do you guys think about pineapple on pizza? This is... No, this is out of hand. No. That's where I draw the line with this discussion. You guys are ridiculous. I do love pizza. Haven't had pineapple on pizza in a while. I don't have an opinion about pineapple on pizza. I just figured it would get chat going. I had a frozen pizza just before the stream today. Time to redeem myself for the Russell Pass. Which was just a stupid controller. Like, I don't know why it's happening, I gotta fix it, but... It wasn't reaction time, so it's fine. Like, I don't mean to shut down discussion. This is just not a good time for it in a run. Just because the conversation got a little ridiculous doesn't mean that I want to just not have it. It just means not during a run. mouth. Not terrible. Biggest run killer after Whitney is Red. Again. It's one potion. This is a little bit worse, right? Stats are comparable. Stats are a little bit worse. Maybe actually about the same. Yeah, but it actually doesn't make that much of a difference to have 4 instead of 12. Like, yeah. It's just Haunter and Gengar, really. Why? Always confusion. Wait, no, this health is not high enough. What? God damn it. Late underground Jolteon. 50 HP and he can fucking kill you. Yeah, I mean, I'm dead to a critical. I was dead to a critical. It was actually, but only if he got the high roll on both. The second one was in a range after he low rolled the first one. Like, I should have done Vaporeon first. Just was thinking 50 was enough, but I mean, you need 51. 51. Even with this god defensive Toto, I still didn't have enough, because Espeon. Yeah, I was wrong. I didn't look at my... I just misread my stats, miscalculated. It is actually 4, which is great. No speed tie on Sabrina. I believe this is no e-speed, yeah. Thank you. Saves like 5.5 seconds too. Toss. This guy hard. Got the paralyzed cure berry, so let's just heal. Thank you. use two serfs on this fight. How does this work now if I still have the Paralyzed Kiberi? Magmite setup? Or do I not even equip it? I don't remember. Alright, I still have it. Alright, it stays on. Forget whether that dies. That looked. Get my element. Rockets. Do they come back? Neat. Alright, this is the big one for spinners. This is the big spinner split. No Chocorino. Just don't fuck up. Take this. That was good. Although now Surf PP, I don't know. Yeah, this really sucks. Like, it's just a brutal split. Four spinners, all useless EXP, or three of them useless and one of them really slow. Going to be hard to record from here, but can't complain given how good the time was until I hit her. She's better to hit than the other one. Thank you. Okay, Ernest is very, very bad to hit. Very, very, very bad to hit. Not run over, but close. Wait. Shit, I had an extra headbutt. I'm dumb. Guess I could use it. Chop. Why did I think I needed to use an extra? Inventory being this condensed. Good. Alright, well, I'm very happy with my execution with those spinners. Disappointed that I hit one, but it was the best tip out of the four to hit. Attack. Okay. end up mattering. Yes, yeah, maybe this is not the right play. So just a scroll, whatever. What? It is almost 3 years old, and not a very popular category at the moment. Okay, I brought it down by one. Cool. Ah, boy, it's gonna start to hit a spinner. Yeah, because I X-attacked twice, then it always kills with a crit. My name is Ixarian Yu. I was born with bad luck and good execution, but only when I'm not doing text boxes. Someone say shiny? So, like, what was my spinner execution other than Russell this run? Has it been, like, it's been alright except movement. The last five spinners have been really good. Bigger concerns are the spinner inside of Rocket Hideout here. His name is Grunt6. And then Joyce. This is two spinners, but one of them was mostly my fault, the first one of them. Thank you. I was telling myself that, but I probably still would have forgotten it because I always. This run is pretty good, but hit a spinner on the last split, so it's not god pace. It's just good pace. Oh, see, I forgot. Like, it literally, like clockwork, dude. And I remembered at the last second, but I forgot. Like, it's so funny. Like, it is actually the hardest trick in the game to clear that repel text box because I am a fidgeter and my hand goes to fidget with something whenever there's an opportunity. And when you're just doing movement like that, there's an opportunity to use your other hand to fidget with stuff, not knowing that the repel is coming up to fuck your shit. But Gen 2 lag means you can sometimes react. In time. Yeah. My head. It's not fun. It can, like, I don't know. It's like kind of stretching, like putting your hand behind your head. I what do I do? Like, I just put it here and sometimes lightly scratch. Like you would a cat, like you scratch the back of your cat's head. I suppose that's not an attractive quality in a human, is it? Well, it's okay. I got the text box, so all is well. No, it's like, where's the Sayaka? Image from Madoka. Which one is it? No, not those. Where is it? Alright, well, rip. Gotta focus on not forgetting to talk to the girl. Like, where she has, she's, like, smiling with her eyes closed, and then, like, has her hand on the back of her head. It's like episode 4 or 5, I want to say. I want to say 5, but it might have been 4. She's in her outfit. Under that. Alright, here we go. Need to pass this dude. Good. Gotta pass him one more time. Oh, it's both hands behind her head, that's what it is. Or wait, no, it's not, I don't know. Whatever, it's fine. Sayaka was like, one of my least favorite characters at first, but then she grew on me. Good night, Edgy. Yes. Yeah, that. Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure that's it. Well, that's both hands, so maybe I remembered it wrong. I think that was good though. I don't think I can really get a whole lot better than that on a walking pass. I'm not gonna rewatch it, but Just have to trust that that was correct. Made it past him, though. That's great. That guy is the hardest spinner to dodge the rest of the run, except Douglas, which you just saved for. I mean, she's still, like, fourth, right? I still have Homura, Madoka, and Kyoko above her, but, like, it's like... She's a much higher fourth than she was on the first watch. Kyoko is great. Yeah, SS. It was a good direction, but he had been facing it for a while, which made it less likely to get past him. She was great for how little screen time she got. Like, for... Yeah, like... Kyoko's character development is, like, best character development I've ever seen in such a short period of time. Like, what, 3 episodes or something, and she's been, like, fully fleshed out as a three-dimensional character. Very impressive, and she's likable. Dude, why does this... It's pretty fucking likely to die. 15. I mean, it wasn't like... Like getting fucked by these electrodes every round. Like, she is like the fourth character, the fourth most developed character. So considering that, it's pretty good. But yeah, I don't type them in. I just click a box. It's a 3-hour run, so there's plenty of downtime. Oh, I like Nanachi too. I don't know, character development is a weird thing for me. Like, I might overrate it. Sometimes in shows that I like, because like character development can be really good, but I won't appreciate it if the show is not doing it for me. Let me make sure I don't do something dumb here. Cool. I don't know how that didn't soft reset. I pressed soft reset because that was like he's facing down, and then I went to AB start select, but I just didn't press them all, so we're good. Anyway, so like Better Call Saul, right? That the spin-off from Breaking Bad, which is critically acclaimed because mostly like the character development is really solid. So I've been watching that, and I'm like, I've watched through season 3 now. And it's good, but like, I'm not as into it, and I don't consider it to be as good as Breaking Bad, because, like, I don't... like the rest of the show, I don't know, the plot points are very significantly worse, more contrived, less exciting, more predictable. So like the characters are fleshed out well, and they're, you know, oh right, this is a thing. Oh, this is nice. Speed tie dugong into rest. Wow. Anyway, so yeah, like, the character development is really good, but it's hard for me to, like, I have to, like, remind myself of that, because, like, the other stuff isn't doing it for me. I mean, it's not bad, it's just not, it's not great. This is gonna be really hard now, fucking dugong. If I hit any spinner, it's gonna be really hard to record. And then, so like, Madoka, the strength of Madoka is, like, the plot and the way everything is used. Like, every second of the show is used for something. There's no filler episodes. There's all of the lighthearted moments. Again, is this where this call goes? All of the lighthearted moments are, like, they fit well. And yet, like, the plot's really good, and the soundtrack's really good, and the art style's really good, and the character development, for me, was strong because I liked the characters and I liked the show, but for a lot of other people, it was a little bit shallow, and I think, like, really, it's the character development in Madoka is quite good for how long the show is and how much it packs in, but, you know, it isn't as deep as, you know, for example, like Steins Gate, that the character development of Okabe is, like, significantly deeper than anything in Madoka. That'll have to do. Okay, good. That was good. Okabe's the protagonist in Steins Gate. But, like, I thought that Okabe's development was significantly strengthened by Steins Gate Zero, but Steins Gate Zero had so many, like, unnecessary scenes and one very unnecessary character. So it's like, I have to remind myself of how strong the character development is because the overall impression wasn't that great. Hunter x Hunter. Oh, Abbott. Thank you. turn 6-3. Godfather. That wasn't the strength of it, I would say, of the series. But it wasn't bad either. So this is basically the same stat line for Rocket, for the Rocket section as I had last run. In case it wasn't boring enough for you last time, we now have the exact same run again. Good ol' Rocket Hideout. However, this time, I spent some time today getting my damage range charts organized and finding my old charts that I discarded when we switched into A, or that I've filed in a different Excel spreadsheet. So now I know what all these ranges are. So this is a 90% range. You guys can get hype for the 10% chance of getting this range into wrap. But I do like this section, it's actually fun to play when you're on a good run. To chill, think about what comes next. The hardest part to learn in this run is spinner execution, like how to dodge spinners optimally. It's very hard to do well, and you have to do it fast. In addition to passing spinners, you have to know how to deal with a run that hits a spinner, like the effect of the experience and the money can be quite significant at times. Well, you've routed it in advance. But you gotta remember it and be able to adapt sometimes. That was weird. Get food, you mean, like, get food that you already have at your place, right? Because isn't that, like, 4:50 a.m. for you? This is what, 42%, 45%? On the Porygon? Missed it last round. You can get food anytime if you have a car here, but like within walking distance there isn't anything really open after like 10. Except fast food places, and those are open until like 1. Yeah. Sounds yummy. Alright, no poison this time. Por favor. So I have my Paralyze Cure Berry. So we do Magnemite set up here. YOLO. That would have been really fucking dumb if that didn't work. Probably was not a good idea to do that, but it saved time. You just need to stop for that guy, but sometimes it's like you try to stop and then you don't. And you hit him. Same thing with the guy, the rotator. Thank you. way to Ice Path. Oh, can I surf? No, I can't surf another one of these. Can I? No. Or wait, what? My note. My notes say I can do this. I have an extra ice punch. It's going well. One silly mistake early on, and other than that, it's been good execution and good luck. Stats are decent for the rest of the game. Like, they're alright for the rest of the game. Good enough. Because the experience just doesn't get you enough unless you hit a spinner, which I didn't this run. It's 15 seconds of extra movement to do them early. Okay, so 38 and 39 range. God, I really hope I have my Paralyze Cure Berry. That's so fast when that happens. And this just dies, because I have perfect special. Yeah, Pokerus is a meme. You can manipulate it, but it takes multiple frame-perfect inputs. This is close with one spinner. Like four, or it might only be like two or three. But Pokerus doesn't do very much. The effect is not that great. I mean, if you get it very early, it could be pretty good, but Pokerus is, like, your Pokemon have this illness, and it causes them to gain twice the stat EXP that it normally does from battles. Or in later gens, it's Eevees. Get him! Nice. You get it off a battle. Yes, it is. Why wouldn't it be? It's not like if you walk in front of him, then that clears a path. It's just a very standard situation where it's faster to talk to him, even though it's two extra steps. The exclamation point takes more time to appear than the time it takes you to walk two steps. But then the first two rockets, you have to let them see you because you can't. There's no path to talk to them. You missed Paralyze Cure Berry strats on Rival, where you can set up on the Magnemite because it just Thunder Waves you and you have your Paralyze Cure Berry. It's pretty lucky to keep it after, through Morty. Like hot or warm? Yeah, this is like the worst time of the year for you guys, right? The chance of getting paralyzed by dragon breath is... what, like... 8%? So better to just use it there, so you don't, like, get confused by the Golbat, or poisoned, or criticaled by the Meganium. Besides, you need the pink bow for Claire to get a good range on her Kingdra with return. So wait, what is the state of air conditioning down there? Because, like, in the southern U.S. states, it's like everybody has air conditioning, and it's, like, often on all the time. I mean, it's expensive, but, like, it's common. Do you guys have that? When it gets, you know, to be this time of year? Or is that, like, only super rich people? What? Wait. How did that happen? Oh, yep. Saving for Douglas. Yep. Good to know. Good to know. So I lost time to that, but I had never been in that situation before. Because I've never had a run that hit Douglas and then... never had a Totodile run that hit Douglas and then reset. Ah, that sucks. I guess you guys get used to it, because, like, I could not imagine that kind of heat this time of year without air conditioning. Percent on the gold bats. This is scary. Okay. Oh, this is gonna be a bad split now, but... get the next two ranges. It's okay. Arbok's very, very favorable. Vileplume's at 62%. Good. Snow is pretty cool, it's just a pain to deal with. If it happens all winter like it does in Minnesota. And slush. It's just wet all the time. No paralyzed cure barrier. Silly start. Otherwise it was fine. Just missed the, which one I missed. Oh well. Not too bad. Thank you.
So I got a ways to go, but yes.
Red's the big threat. Oh, what's up, JT? Runs are pretty good. I didn't... Why is Dratini a problem? Why did that not work? Underground. I do think that's cool, and I... can't really, it's hard to find something to do in life that reaches people in such a diverse manner, the way this does. So it is actually... really cool to think about the fact that, like, literally everywhere except for, like, the really poor countries, you got people watching. And, you know, it's just... if you're gonna get to know your viewers, there's more to get to know, there's more interesting discussion to have in chat. It's not an echo chamber. Alright, so these can live. 45. Not at 46. Good. Hyper beam. Yes. She can't heal if she's hyper beaming or recharging. Don't call out the lurkers. Even if it's a simple thing, like, nobody needs to chat if they don't want to. So I'll lose time to record on this split, because the record's got unbeatable luck, plus it doesn't... you always lose time here. But as long as I don't hit Joyce, or mess up the movement, it's fine. Because it like crit Slowbro and got no Confuse Ray from Zatu and got all the Meganium range and a fast spinner and skipped taking the Mart, which is a YOLO strat that I will not be doing. Actually, I'll do it if I hit Joyce, but otherwise. Thanks, sweetie. I might want to skip it anyway. Like, I have so many hypers. It's so YOLO, though. I'm not gonna skip unless something goes wrong. Definitely am good, though, for everything if I don't get Umbreon or Pika status. The Pika could just kill me with stupid train. Shut up. Thank you. No. Okay, what was that though? How did the cursor go up? I mean, the cursor going up doesn't really matter. Except I think it caused me to pause a little bit longer before I did the second one, so. That's fine though, like that's fine. We made it. Movement and spinner. Not really gamble. Russell and Olivia, they're like the two fastest spinners to hit. I only have three hypers. Okay, I am gonna buy full restores. I mean, I thought I had four for some reason. So it says 81%. Yeah, it is. Well, this is gonna be a lot of time loss in this split. Slow text boxes, bonk, kinda slow joists, lots of criticals. Buying full restores. Psychic. Fuck off. Three runs in a row. No! Oh dear. Okay, just crit the slow bro. Actually, I have a 3% chance of dying here. Well, actually, wait. I don't know. This could, I'm a little worried. This could be a lot of time lost here, the way this is lining up. Could be fine, though. Just crit the slow bro, dude. Just crit him. Reverse order. I'll take it. Like, you can get psychic there, and that's just like 65 damage after the special defense drop. Not as bad as I thought, actually. Three more spinners, but one of them you have to pass twice. We've also got some big time loss potential on this fight with a Crobat range of 71%. And then on Karen being being slower than Gengar, not speed tied. She has a lick. Paralyze. Die, die, die. Yes.
Thank you.
heck? How did I save 6 seconds there? I've been saving like 4. Okay, no Confuse Ray, and no Lick Para, and no Spite. Use curse. Actually, if this lives, it's going to use spite, isn't it? It's kind of scary. Curse. All right. Luckiest Karen fight ever. No sand attack, crit Umbreon, and faster than Gengar. Alright, so what do I want to do here? Go for the range? No. She does. So 1 in 16 to die then. I did so much less than the last one, but just don't crit me. Okay. Let's go. 15 seconds behind yesterday, so I'm not bad. Stats are basically the same for Kanto. Slightly better, actually. Three spinners, and a few ranges. Don't know who I'm returning. Two things, I guess. I guess just the... Who am I returning? Just one thing. I just altered the normal strat. Thank you.
Okay, first spinner coming up after this fight. But it's only the first of two passes on this spinner. Because they have to progress the plot. No. That was bad, but we made it. No risk. So focused on our next movement. God. This crystal. Shit. I don't have the attack to do this. Okay, well then, okay, I'll just do one. Thank you. I don't think they meant for it to be that much of a gauntlet. They just scattered random trainers around Kanto. If you strictly try to beat the game, then it feels like a gauntlet. But if you're exploring Kanto, which I think was the intent... God damn it. And, yeah, there's just trainers everywhere with lame, weak pokes. What is still scary? There's still three spinners left to pass. It's gonna be very close if I hit one of them. Barely be able to beat record. And then there's the final fight of the game, which is 50% to go well and 50% to go poorly, and usually when it goes poorly, it's just you lose a minute or... You lose a lot of time. Can't afford to lose that, most likely, so... Basically four scary things left. Yeah, simple but good. He's a great artist. Everything he does is really solid. Thank you. Misty and Power Plant and Sabrina. Hell? It's time. I did get two quick attacks. Range, coin flip, basically. Slightly unfavorable, actually. Yes! Except for the quick attacks. Alright, here we go. The big split. Two spinners, and then the Espeon range. Come on. We can play conservatively here, but not too conservatively. Nothing too extreme. Saffron. Saffron. Thank you. Not again. Okay. My sadness. It's fine. I got through. I don't know why I even do that, honestly. It doesn't help. From that position to pause again. It's just... So that is a GameCube controller, one of three. Now, Sabrina's gym for two of three. And after Sabrina, we get Tom. Spawn, but wrong direction. No! Oh, damn it. Okay, no sand. Should have the defense for blue. Oh, no need speed. That was a very sketchy split, but accomplished what I wanted to. No bad passes. No disaster. Eleven seconds behind yesterday's run. Take that. Come on, Tom. Don't fuck me again. Not two runs in a row. Shit. Okay. You know what? That's fine. Like, that was weird, but I think, honestly, that was fine. I didn't even think about doing the YOLO strat, but it was actually a pretty good setup for that. I think it was better to not, because all I need to do is dodge Tom, and this is free. Barring stall Pikachu, so we're good, we're good. It's fine. It's all just Pikachu. And I guess Espeon, but it's fine. Imagine that. Like, not only does the fucker block me, but then he just moves out of the way as if to say, I only moved there to fuck with you. Jesus. There is no pattern. The cans are just for decoration in this game. There's no puzzle. T- talk about that after the run. It's not over yet. Yes, I will call it record. There won't be any. There just might be some confusion. This category is basically what we ran before Minip was discovered, and there's dozens of runs of it. This is very much competing against, like, top times. Good, lucky runs from back in the day. So it's just been a while since people have done this. I don't mean this as any sort of criticism against the PSR community, but like when you have admins in the community who are not really focused on changing anything to the leaderboards and are just kind of waiting for there to be a discussion, like the admins aren't really active, they're just around if they're needed, so it's not really like they're the ones who actually add the leaderboards. You can't just add a leaderboard if you're not an admin, but, like, the admins don't really take the initiative. So it's not a criticism, it's just saying, like, if a category needs to be made, it's gonna happen because the runners push for it, and so now I'm pushing for this, and no one is saying it shouldn't be a category. It just isn't official yet because the admins usually take a wait-and-see approach. It is a recognized category, it just doesn't have a speedrun.com leaderboard because the admins haven't gotten around to it yet. Like, that's literally just it. Like, they just have not gotten around to it because they're busy people doing other things. No one has said it shouldn't be a category. It was set 2.5 years ago. Yeah, Brock is very low for hints. It's just useless criticals. He's alive. He's been practicing for GDQ. And then he'll be gone at GDQ for a week. So don't expect him to stream too much in the next little bit, but he will be back strong after GDQ, and of course, do watch his GDQ run. His race with PokeGuy. It's gonna be nice. Oh shit, there he is! The man. Wait, what got banned? Trust ya. Thank you. Gunner knows this subject well. I don't know what that is. Why are you making this the subject of the chat? Just... path. It's fine. Just enter the fight. Just get into the blue fight. There's a lot of time here. It's fine. It's fine. Love no e-speed. Don't love triple wing attack. More. I don't know how I did not lose more. Alright. Alright, let's do this. Get those Kevin Turtles going for charm. This is it. Let's fucking do it. Finally. Thank you. Where? The fuck was I? That was weird. Oh, we all have. Health. It's not enough, is it? Excuse me? The hell? Oh, that's fitting. I didn't press start. Alright, well, it's fun.